So I want to start from the beginning, because I am a skier at heart, and we started a company because I didn't think there was any good ski bags.
So how come Jon Olsson became so successful at everything he was doing? He has been skiing, he has been ski jumping, he has been going with sports cars, created companies. He's now created a YouTube channel that has over 1.5 million followers, or somewhere around there. How the fuck is he doing? Well, that's what we're going to explore in today's episode.
How do you afford to drive a Lambo? We only see you chilling and swinging in the pool and jumping cliffs.
So we'll call that today's question.
Yeah.
Because I feel like people always, I see in the comments like, wait, who's this guy? How can YouTube make him a Lambo? So I don't like to talk about money, but since we're 24/7 with you guys, I would say the reason that I can drive a Lambo is because I was a pro skier for 15 years with sponsorship money, and I was pretty good at working with the sponsors. So that is probably where most of my income has come from. And then of course with douchebags, that is probably my sort of best business thing I've done, because in the pace that we're growing, hopefully that can become a company that's worth a lot of money.
So yep.
That's kind of my strategy that we do YouTube now, because that is first of all, we love filming, so that way we have a reason to film everything. It also gives us a bit of income so that I can focus on growing douchebags, so one day when we can sell it, you know, I gotta...
You can retire.
Yeah.
He does tend to get really obsessed.
Whenever I do things, I get obsessed with it. It's like whatever I'm doing at that specific moment, that is all that matters. A good example is that I started bowling, and a couple days after I started, I found myself spending 8 hours a day in the bowling alley alone, traveling with two bowling balls, bowling shoes when I went on ski trips. So I get hyper obsessed with things. Like when I wanted to get a red camera, I would spend hours and hours and hours and hours reading everything there was to read about it. And I guess for the people around you, that can get a bit exhausting at times when you're just that obsessed with things. So I'm trying to, that is something that I haven't really learned how to master yet, because it's just when I get into something, it's all the way and I can't do it halfway.
He does everything 100%.
Whenever I did things, I did them 110%, and I did them as well as I could, and I worked really hard, and that generated success on a lot of different fields, and that enabled me to live the life I do now and do things I only dreamed about when I was a kid.
He is full of creative ideas.
But on the creative side of things, as soon as someone mentions an idea of some sort, my head just goes into, it's like a turbo kicks in, and it starts spinning, and I think about all these ideas that I have on how to tweak ideas, how to work with a company, how to do marketing, how to rebuild a car, whatever it is. I love analyzing and thinking and being creative with that, so.
He has super fun.
I do a lot of product briefs, and I'm not a master of Photoshop, but I do a lot of the designs for the Red Bull bag with the camel pattern, making sure the camel bowls are in the size that I want and all this stuff. So it's super fun. So it's like a hobby turned into a job. But in terms of like getting rich, I don't take any money out of douchebags. Every profit that we make is being put back into the company to help it grow. And then eventually, hopefully one day, someone's gonna say, hey, I wanna buy your company.
And then you're gonna say yes, because yeah. Richard told me to sell.
Always sell when you can sell.
Yeah.
No, we don't wanna sell now because we're having too much fun.
He is totally committed at everything he's doing. He goes all in.
Commitment level extreme.
I think that's typical June. Like,
he's
we're
crazy.
Here to shoot, but as soon as he got his ideas,
He has got a small team that can pivot very fast.
You know what it's all about? It's all about a small, tight crew that can move fast and get a lot of different things in 2 seconds.
Yeah. And close-ups with a long lens.
and he follows his passion.
Ski racer to like big air skier, back to ski racer, back to dabbling in like everything, and then to YouTube.
Yeah.
How'd you do that?
Not much strategy, more doing what I want to do, and if I want to do something, then I'm going to do that 400%, and I think that has been the reason that it's worked, because it's not like I'm like, all right, grand master plan.
Yeah.
Of course, sometimes there's a couple thoughts that go into strategy, but most of all, it's been going to something that I really want to do, because if you want to do it, then you're more likely to do it well.
He lives under pressure, under fear, anxiety. So he has this constant uncertainty.
Being very insecure about the future makes you be more aware, do more things maybe on the side so that you have more options if you want to do something different.
I totally dig that. You have this like fear and anxiety thing that motivates you.
He makes one vlog every day.
And we did one vlog, we did one the next day, and then all of a sudden we've done vlogs every day for 3-4 weeks. And then we just said, yeah, we'll do it every day for a year.
Boom.
Same thing again, you know, you get competitive and you see the subs increasing, you see the views, and you see a development, and then, I mean, from anything I've done in my life, daily vlogging is 4 times harder, like more
really?
Energy sucking.
Okay.
Just do it.
That's my advice. You want something, you go out there and you work for it, and then you work some more if you want more of it. And the harder you work, the more you can do. So that's my general advice. And then just build whatever you think is cool. And don't listen to anyone. People tell you it's stupid, do it anyway, because you know it's your build, your idea, so just do it.